incredible monks and nuns and all the Buddhist followers and friends of the Dharma. Happy Vesak Day. So, first of all, I'd like to really thank for this opportunity to share from the Mahayana Buddhism, this Dharma talk. And I also would like to thank Mission of Sri Lanka and Thai sort of agree my suggestion. So thank you very much. But at the same time, I wrote a little notes because a couple of years ago we started the Mahayana chanting in addition to the Theravada traditions. And then the idea itself is you know, this is a celebration of the Buddha's life. So all the Buddhism altogether should be celebrated. So in that case, then maybe you start with adding to the Theravada Buddhist chanting, and maybe it'd be nice to have a Mahayana chanting as well. And since we have the Theravada talk and the monks talks, so what about doing a Mahayana talk? So I just say a little notes. But it doesn't mean that I'm supposed to be talking here today. So this is some mind miscalculation that I only said 2 weeks ago, and which is so probably what I mean is that next year. Next year maybe you should have some probably Mahayana chanting, I mean Mahayana talks as well. And since I said that, and then I don't mean future is not this year but next year. So since I said I thought I should talk. When they say please come and give a talk, maybe that's my responsibility. I should be responsible to my words. So that's why I'm standing here. But at the same time, my name is again, there's a mic there. So I'm from the Mahayana tradition, but particularly in Japanese. So I don't represent all the Mahayana Buddhism, but yet some of the Mahayana tradition that I have. And so I'm very grateful for this Vesak started, including Mahayana and other traditions. And so hopefully, you know, since I've started requesting, maybe I just added a little more request, which is maybe like this morning we have the Dana ceremony, and I think it would be nice to have more Mahayana group, but also maybe dance, more dance here too. So maybe nice to have invitation to, especially to the nuns and other group, so that we were really celebrating the feeling of the togetherness, celebrating this Buddha's birthday, and sharing, because this is itself is a, for me, it's an idea of Mahayana. Maha means big or large, Yana is the vehicle. So in a way, I think the important part of Mahayana practice should be the bigger picture, not just the narrow mind. Like that today for the chanting part, four great parts are chanted by Korean monk. And so in part of it, you know, sentient beings are numberless, I say them all. But you know, that's a big thought. You know, how can it be possible to, but yet need to have such mind? I think it, you know, would be really different. You know, we're talking about unification, and then we have a world right there. But when we have that kind of view, I mean, if each one has a view of thinking of the world, you know, we're only thinking of how can I make money, or how can I make, you know, my family, or my everything is by my mind, me, or whatever. And so, but instead, maybe each one can start thinking of like a bigger picture, maybe instead of just narrow-minded, you know, even desires. You know, you want to make it really good, but then at the same time, this desire become like a, yeah, so that I can become enlightened or something. So that's a bigger, you know, theory. And I think sense of Mahayana Buddhism itself is the, I think after even like, this is a historical part, I guess, the Mahayana Buddhism stuff, but it is the movement of the lay people movement also, because Buddhism become more like a only belong Dharma, belong to like monks and nuns, but rather, you know, not regular people. So one of the reasons that the Mahayana movement came like in the first century is the movement of lay people. So this the Buddha's teaching is to everyone, not just the one particular people, not just the one only, but also other, you know, regular people too. And so one time Buddha says something like, that my teaching is like a water. So, you know, this water does not discriminate anybody, but anybody who took the water, drink the water, can ease the thirst. So that's the part of the teaching of the Buddha. So from that sense, you know, the Mahayana movement should be something, you know, this is a teaching to everyone, not just Buddhist only, you know, all the, it could be Christian, atheist, and anybody who would like to hear, practice that Dharma is available. And so that's the one of the most important part of the teaching. And another part of the thing he says, modern technology is nice when you move, when it works, but somehow my computer stopped. Anyway, I have to rely on my own understanding. But there's an understanding of each human life, or actually lives, have a Buddha nature. And then this particular understanding is that having the Buddha nature itself is a very important one, which is Tathagata Dharma, or is his potential to become enlightened. So which means each one has a potentiality to become enlightened. Whether I like him or her or not, he or she has potential to be enlightened. You know, so I mean, this idea itself, I believe, is a very, very important one, because that way you respect your own life, but also you respect others' life. And you know, maybe they may do, you know, violence and so forth. Maybe they don't know why they are doing the violence. So maybe that's an opportunity to really teach, or at least trust, at least those people has a potential to be, you know, maybe awaken and then change their mind, so that we can work together somehow. And I believe, you know, myself, as I said, from Japan, Japanese first constitution was based upon Buddhism, 17th chapter by Shotoku. And his particular 17th chapter based upon this understanding of, you know, each one have the guidance. Once you have guided, then you can possibly awaken. And then so whether you are maybe now not much of the understanding of the life, but yet when you have the opportunity to learn, then you can change your life. And everybody can be changed. And so that idea of changing is a very important one. So that based upon each one has a Buddha's nature, or the potential to become enlightened. And so which means each one has the mind of loving kindness possibly after you cultivate. And then each one can bring the light of wisdom to this world. And then each one can bring the respect to all the lives. Then maybe each one can bring the good luck to our lives. This is my four L's these days that I'm talking about. But then the first L of loving kindness, or love, L. Second as a light. And then the third one as life. And then the fourth one is a good luck. So I hope this gathering, or, you know, with each of us can cultivate the mind of life, and love and love. And I can finish with the short meditation. So join me in Gashem. Praise your palms together. May all living beings be happy, well, and peaceful. May we also cultivate the mind of love, or loving kindness, compassion, light of wisdom, value the life, precious life, the life of potential to become enlightened, and bring us all luck to our life, to to our society and to our world and this planet of Earth. ガンヌシクドクビオドゴセイシサイドウォンスゴダイシンゴージョウアンダーコー願わくはこの孤独をもって平等に一切の孤独を生まなし広大心を起こしてあんな国に往生千南無系仏南無系法南無系僧南無南無宿泊